Came back to not so nice surprise of a flat tire. Yes! What's up, guys? Welcome back to a video. It feels like a while since I've done this. Last time was quite a while back because I was on, I've been on holiday for a little while. Today is the day that I am changing the exhaust finally on my Turbo S. Last startup with the stock exhaust. Yeah, we gotta change that. That is not sufficient. First step is gonna be transporting this, which as you can see is the new Quicksilver exhaust, to the garage where we're getting it fitted. Actually not that big, so it should fit no problem. Okay, well, I mean, it's in. It doesn't look exactly ideal, but it's in. All right, now I've got these bags because I'm gonna spend a few days at my new house. I don't know if you saw the house that I put a video on when it was under construction in Saint-Tropez, which is a first project of this type that I've kind of embarked on. It's basically finished, 95% finished, and it's gonna be the first time I see it in that state, and that will be the next video on the channel. I'll give you a full tour. But it does mean I wanna spend a few days there, so I've got some bags with me. So the Porsche is pretty full today between the exhaust and the bags. Ooh. And I got my cleaning products. Yes! Okay, let's go. On the road with my new passenger, this Quicksilver exhaust. I'm actually so pumped to hear this thing because I've never heard it before. And I know that may sound weird because I've heard Quicksilver exhaust on Turbo S's. I think I've probably watched every single possible video of a Turbo S with a Quicksilver exhaust. I also had a friend who had a Turbo S with a Quicksilver exhaust. But this one is a special one because it is the first of this type. It was developed specifically by Quicksilver, so huge thank you to them. I'm gonna put all their links on the screen down below. Huge thanks to them because they developed this exhaust specifically for this car, and then I'm sure you'll be able to go get it yourselves if it's of interest to you in the future. But this is the first car that it will officially be on, apart from obviously the development car. Now the idea is that there were a few options from Quicksilver, and it's all a question of taste. You know, some people want to change the exhaust, just to have a little change, so Quicksilver offer that. For me, that wasn't quite enough noise. And then there was like my friend's Turbo S exhaust, full decat, everything, which was just, I mean, so noisy. Sounds incredible, but for daily use for me, it was maybe a little bit hardcore. Also, I wanted to keep the warranty on my car, and that limits you with exactly what kind of exhaust you can do. So it was kind of like checking with the Porsche dealer, checking with Quicksilver, exactly what we could do to get a lot of noise, but not too much, and still have enough for it to be a proper change and keep the warranty. So those are the kind of three criteria, which, I mean, we'll see how it sounds. I think they'll probably knock it out of the park. They put all the development into it, so yeah, it should be pretty epic, and I'm really pumped to hear it. So that is right there, and it's actually surprisingly light and surprisingly small. As you saw, we can store it in the car pretty easily. Now, also, what happened is I was away. If you follow me on Instagram, my Instagram will be on the screen right now. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I was away on holiday for a little while. And when I came back from that holiday, I came back to not so nice surprise of a flat tire on this car. So it was a slow puncture, which I basically picked up a nail probably driving on the last drive before parking the car, and came back and the tire was completely dead. So bit of a nightmare, but I found this interesting because I was like, okay, what do I do now? What do you do? This is my first Porsche. What's the process with this? And when I bought this car, they told me about the Porsche assistance program. And so I was like, well, look, this is the moment to do it. So when you buy the car, you get 2 years of Porsche assistance, which is, let me switch these parking sensors off, included with the car. And that basically means that if ever you need to get towed or you have any issues with the car, they will cover all of that for you, apart from any extra parts that you need. So for example, if you need to replace the tire, they won't cover the cost of the tire. But it's great because they'll also send someone kind of straight away to your house. So this car is a 2019, so I obviously had the 2 years, but then it also came with what's called a 2+2 pack, which means the extended 2 year Porsche assistance. So super convenient. So I just called up, same day, there was a mechanic sent to my house who came and managed to fix actually the existing tire. So I'm not sure exactly how I feel about that, to be honest. I'm still gonna change the tires because I'm planning on doing that anyway soon, because there's something coming, which, yeah, a few more little plans for this car, which you'll see in due course. Anyway, so I already ordered some tires with Pirelli, and they should be here in not too long. So I figured, okay, you know what, I'll just drive it. Right now it's holding its tire pressures really nicely. I'll drive it with the little fix that they've put on it, which they said was fine to drive for 6 months to a year, no problem. But anyways, I'd rather change. But yeah, I thought that was kind of interesting. My first kind of little issue I've had with the Turbo S, and it was fixed really easily, to be honest, and didn't cost me anything. So flat tire, no problem. Porsche assistance works really well. So if you have a Porsche, good to know. And if you're thinking about getting a Porsche, good to know as well. Anyway, we're about to arrive. They are not messing around. I've been here for a couple of minutes. The car's already been lifted, and they're getting started on kind of getting rid of things in the back. Porsche 911s are not the easiest for this kind of project because everything is so compact in the rear of the car. Everything is just put into the rear of the car. But yeah, and it's so cool seeing it up like this. You kind of get to know your car a little bit better because you can get under it, look around in all the nooks and crannies and see all the details of the car. So I always enjoy watching the work go on and learning kind of the process of how the exhaust was put on and just kind of knowing what's going on. I enjoy it quite a bit. But these guys, they're cool. They'll do anything performance. So if you're in the area, they can do anything from exhaust. They can even convert your car to ethanol. They can redo the mapping of your car, brakes, anything that touches performance of your car. These are your guys. The moment has come to see the new exhaust. Look at these are the sports cats. Oh wow, they're really nice sports cats. Look at that, beautiful. This is the exhaust itself. Look at this, super simple, just one pipe, really light as well. I'm gonna gain a bit of weight with this because the original exhaust, if you look at it, look here, it's huge. Well, it's always the case on the original. So we're gonna change these, the cats right there. And then that's the original box. Yeah, I mean, it's gonna be a big difference, especially in weight as well. Kind of look at all the radiators and how everything's packed in here.
Oh, I'm so excited.
So for those wondering, where are the exhaust tips? We're actually gonna keep the original ones. So we're gonna keep these exhaust tips right here. You can see all the pieces are coming off as we speak.
And the idea behind that is I want everything that I'm gonna do to this car to be kind of really discreet.
I love the kind of low keyness. Kind of ish, I mean, if a 911 can ever be low key,
of this car. So I wanna keep it this way. So original exhaust tips, and then anything else, which you'll see, there are other things coming for this car, is gonna be very discreet, and that's the way I want it.
Out with the old, in with the new.
There we go, we got the new system, and then we got the old one right there.
So the Quicksilver and original Porsche. You see the difference in size and therefore weight? And also, something tells me that's gonna sound a lot nicer. Guys, look at this, we've put the tips back on. They're not fixed yet, but it's starting to take shape. From the exterior, you really won't be able to see it's got a modified exhaust, which I like. I can't wait to hear it. Right, guys,
it's the moment.
Look at this, it's all done. Looks, I mean, you wouldn't be able to tell, but now we're gonna get started.
Oh yeah. So pleased. It pops and bangs. Yes! Oh, ouais?
So can you hear the pops and bangs? Apparently it's gonna make even more noise with time. Yes! Oh, it changes the character of a car, especially a car like this that was missing it. It needed this. Thank you, Quicksilver. Thank you, MotorTech. So cool. See, like in normal mode, cruising around like this, perfectly usable. You can daily drive it, no problem at all. That's what I wanted. So it's got those two characters when you spin the wheel right there. Normal, really nice and quiet. And then sport, you'll get all sorts of like pops and bangs and everything. Perfect. Woo-wee! Guys, I am over the moon. I couldn't be happier. I mean, you just saw us kind of blasting it just then, and then now I'm on the motorway. I'm doing, yeah, the speed limit, I'm at 110 kilometers an hour, and the car is, yeah, basically silent. You would never know this wasn't a stock exhaust. And that's exactly what I wanted for long trips, for daily driving, for it to be a little louder than stock so that you still were aware that you were in kind of a powerful car, but very usable. And that's exactly what it is. And then you whack it into sports mode, manual, and then all of a sudden, I mean, how crazy is that? It's the perfect balance, Quicksilver. You guys nailed it with this one. So cool. It's exactly what I described that I wanted at the beginning of the video. Anyway, today's a day of firsts because I'm now on my way to Saint-Tropez to see the finished house for the very first time. It says it could take an hour and 13 minutes, but with it being Saint-Tropez and summer traffic, it could be there in about 9.5 hours. Let's cross our fingers. Check this out. Just arrived at the house. How much has this all changed compared to last time? It's insane. And having the turbo here, look at this. The pool all finished, everything all done. But yeah, I'm not gonna show you too much because I'm gonna do a full house tour, finished house tour. And that will be the next video coming up. So subscribe if you aren't already for that video. And thank you to everyone involved, to Quicksilver, to MotorTech. Thank you to you for watching this video. Thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you very soon. Cheers, guys. Bye-bye.